Hello everyone! Welcome to my The Young and the Restless Homies official channel. I hope everyone is having a wonderful day. Before we begin, please hit the subscribe button and give this video a thumbs up. At Society, Victoria and Cole discuss Claire's request to see Jordan in Oregon. Victoria is concerned that this journey will further hurt Claire, although Cole believes Claire is tougher than they realize and that making this request required guts. They both recognize aspects of themselves in Claire. However, Victoria is concerned about what seeing Jordan may do to Claire, who is delicate. Cole tells them to believe in Claire and her decisions. Claire had a dream at Memorial about Victoria and Cole rejecting her and ordering her not to call them her parents. Later, when Cole and Victoria pay her a visit, she expects them to decline her request. They do, however, offer to assist her in seeing Jordan. Victoria admits that she is concerned about Jordan's impact on Claire. But if this is what she needs, she will do anything she can to make it happen. However, she has one condition: they must accompany her. Claire disagrees, but Cole and Victoria explain that family comes first. Claire eventually accepts Victoria's demand but requests that, while they accompany her, she face her aunt alone. Adam arrives at the workplace and meets Nick, who informs him that he is late. Adam disagrees, claiming he is on time. Nick wishes they had a few minutes to prepare for the meeting with Victor. Nick believes Adam is overconfident, but they both agree that they must collaborate to present their EVRS proposal to Victor. Nick and Adam present Victor on their concept to rename EVRS as Newman Real Ventures. Victor is initially apprehensive due to the expense, but Nick points out that it is an investment in an undervalued company. Victor likes the idea and is delighted to see his sons collaborate for the family business. Following the meeting, Nick and Victor express their worries about Nikki and Victoria. They both agree that they are concerned about Victoria, but Victor reminds Nick that she possesses Newman's strength. Victor is proud of Nick for finding a way to collaborate with Adam despite their differences. Later, Adam sees Sally at Society and tells her about his successful meeting with his father and Nick. Adam points out that the only thing that could top it off is a celebratory supper with her, but she has customers. Sally informs that her client has canceled, and she believes that having lunch and dinner in one day may be too much. However, Sally is willing to live dangerously if Adam does. Audra confronts Kyle about the reason he punched Tucker and asks them to stop fighting. Kyle demands Tucker leave his family alone, particularly Ashley. Tucker, on the other hand, feels Ashley is capable of fighting her own battles and that her wars are dirtier than everyone realizes. Kyle cautions Tucker to quit pursuing the Abbots and promises to come after him in the future. Tucker leaves. Audra insists to Kyle that she was only trying to protect him, but he says he doesn't need it. She implies that Kyle is no match for Tucker since Tucker's hatred against the Abbots is deeply personal, and he is vengeful enough to go all out. Audra informs Kyle that she chooses to take chances with Tucker over him. Kyle shows disappointment and believes that they could achieve great things, but Audra kicks him out. Ashley confides in Jack about Tucker's mind games, which make her doubt her sanity. Ashley adds that this is not the first time she has struggled with her sanity, but she recalls their confrontation in Paris clearly. Tucker is only gaslighting her, Jack assures her. Ashley wonders whether she's mistaken and Tucker is correct, that she embellished what happened as an excuse to dump him. Jack informs her that Tucker dislikes losing and that losing her is his greatest loss, therefore he will go to any length to win her back. Ashley becomes distraught and tells Jack that Tucker is insane if he believes he can win her back in that way. Jack soothes her with an embrace. Meanwhile, Kyle returns home and informs them of his encounter with Audra. He also claims that Tucker walked up and they got into a fight, during which Kyle hit him. Ashley then hurries away, claiming she needs to go elsewhere. Audra sees Tucker downstairs and tells him that she has ended her relationship with Kyle because she doesn't want someone to hold her back. Tucker shows his appreciation for her warning concerning Kyle. Audra claims Kyle had no difficulty betraying her, and she returned the favor. Tucker believes it is excellent that she is getting Kyle out of her system. However, Audra confesses that he isn't the only one she's finally letting go of. Tucker begs her not to abandon him as well, but she says his lovesick revenge plan is a disaster waiting to happen, and she has no interest in it. He denies feeling lovesick and tells her he can't do it without her. Ashley enters and notices the two. Audra reiterates that she is over Tucker and that his promises mean nothing to her anymore. She goes away, sees Ashley, and says, "He's over there. You too, and your twisted dance will never end." Ashley then expresses a desire to speak with Audra. The Young and the Restless spoilers for Thursday, January 11, 2024, remind us that nothing happens in Geno City unless Victor permits it, as Victoria must ask him for a favor on her daughter's behalf. Will Victor grant the Yli and our request? Young and the Restless spoiler highlights. Claire has made it clear to Victoria and Cole that she must maintain a safe distance from them in order to recuperate, but she also needs closure by addressing her Aunt Jordan. Jordan was last seen being carried away by cops after Claire used a gun on her to save Nikki's life. Victor wasn't even present during the confrontation, but somehow, his consent is required to obtain Claire an audience with Jordan, so Victoria asks her father to pull some strings and make it happen. Will Victor grant his daughter and granddaughter's wishes? Here's the obvious question. What's in it for him? Make your choice. I feel sorry for Lauren. She is friendly with Phyllis. Phyllis makes it difficult to be friends with her. Phyllis is currently out to steal Danny from Christine, undermine Diane with Jack, push Summer together with Chance, Daniel with Heather, and remind Nick that she is the genuine love of his life. Phyllis approaches all of these activities in a somewhat unconventional manner. Meanwhile, Lauren continues to cope with all of these people. This is why her commitment is tested on a regular basis. Is this related to all of stuff, or will it be about Nikki? Second time around. Sally has been coy with Adam. She's consented to have lunch. She has accepted to supper. She has agreed to a date. But she has not yet decided to give their love affair another shot. Adam has not given up hope, though. He is available when she is ready. And Sally seemed to be ready. The Young and the Restless spoilers hint at a big disruption between Tucker McCall and Ashley Abbott. What exactly happened in Paris when their honeymoon was cut short? That is the million-dollar question. The party is finished for these two, but the show has made much of the fact that they have differing perspectives on what happened between them. And this is critical since the program appears to be setting up a heated confrontation between Tucker and Kyle Abbott, Michael Mueller. According to spoilers, Kyle will lose control this week, which might have disastrous consequences for him. The Young and the Restless spoilers. Jack Abbott lectures Kyle Abbott. Kyle, Ashley, Diane Abbott, and Jack Abbott have orchestrated Tucker's downfall. The Young and the Restless spoilers. Tucker goes berserk, bloodies Kyle to show who's boss. Tucker was duped into believing Kyle was on his side, and as a result, the Abbotts humiliated him. They did so by revealing his role in a previous scandal cover-up, but it was only the first part of their 1-2 punch. By and our spoilers. Kyle Abbott believes he can handle Tucker McCall. Now that the bear has been poked, Jack repeatedly urged Kyle on the Monday, January 8 episode to be cautious with Tucker. Kyle repeatedly assured him that he had this under control and would bring Tucker to his knees on his own. Oh, what might go wrong? The Young and the Restless spoilers. Kyle Abbott's confrontation. Fans are aware that Ashley believes Tucker is a violent monster who transforms into a raving villain in Paris. But he maintains the opposite, that she misinterpreted his actions. The episode featured flashbacks to that moment, although their memories differed. Why does the show portray Tucker as a violent rageaholic? Kyle is expected to lose control this week, most likely due to Tucker's suspicions. The games are finished now that Audra Charles has exposed Kyle's deception, and Tucker is eager to show Kyle who's boss. Lie and our spoilers. Kyle Abbott's confrontation. Do you, Lai, and our fans Expect this alpha male conflict to end in blood. Is Tucker going to go physical with Kyle, leaving the Abbott family stunned? So what do you guys think about this update? Let me know in the comments below. And if you like my videos, please press like and subscribe for more. I'll see you guys next time.